guilty of murder. That is the verdict today for a Sacramento County man accused in a hit and run that killed a man, his four dogs, and seriously injured his girlfriend.
KCRA 3 Sharkina Shams was in the courtroom and has reaction from the victim's family. Sharkina?
Paul William Walden had three DUIs, three, before the night that he drove into a young couple walking their four dogs in their Carmichael neighborhood. Now, that was 2 years ago. To this day, no one can say whether he was under the influence the night he hit them because he fled the scene. He didn't stop. He was never tested for drugs and alcohol. But for many other reasons, today, the jury found him guilty of murder.
We, the jury, in the above entitled cause, find the defendant, Paul William Walden, guilty of hit and run with death or a serious bodily injury as charged in count three.
One after another, the verdicts were read. Five of them, he was guilty on five separate counts, including second degree murder and manslaughter. The defendant, Paul William Walden, was also found guilty of DUI, but that was for a traffic stop made 3 days later, 3 days after he'd run into Harrison Long Randall, his girlfriend Jemily West, and Jemily's four dogs. Long Randall later died of his injuries in a hospital. Today, we talked to Jemily after the verdicts were read and to the jury foreman, who says the jury never bought Walden's explanation that he fell asleep at the wheel.
I think of them every day. When I think of Harry, it's how much I miss his happy, go lucky attitude.
The key point was the victim said she saw the car coming towards them and swerving and then correcting and then hitting the stop sign. And that was clearly an indication that he was awake.
Now, the jury also found over the last day that Walden ignored numerous opportunities to kick a heroin habit. Sentencing is expected for him in 1 month. Meanwhile, the family of Harrison Long Randall say they'll pursue legislation in California to make DUI laws tougher. Live here in Sacramento, I'm Sharkina Shams, KCRA 3 News.
Charo, thank you.